Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh yes.
Yeah,
oh yes.
Pastor.
Oh yes.
Oh yeah.
Oh yes.
Oh yeah.
Oh yes.
Hey, yo, 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 what's up, man? It's your boy TUSKL today. Mr. Flow So Good, Matiba Totle, Mr. Skipper Mawatwat. Y'all already know, man, and I'm back with you guys with another YouTube video. If you're new to a channel and you watch this video and happen to like what you know you see me doing, please make sure to click that red button and subscribe. Also making sure to click the bell next to that red button because it makes sure that YouTube will notify you when I upload a video. Now, my friends, it seems like AKA and Shane Eagle are back at it again. You guys will already know that, you know, I think about a month back or 2 months back, you know, Shane Eagle basically came out to call out AKA for basically coming out to say that, you know, he made it independent, you know, and his album went platinum independent, and he was just giving advice to young artists on how, you know, they don't really have to sign to a major label in order for them to be successful. Shane Eagle just basically called him out and said, but you were signed before. AKA didn't take kindly to that. He responded with a series of tweets basically saying Shane Eagle's album isn't even gold yet and his album went gold in a week, and basically saying he created Shane Eagle. Now it seems that Shane Eagle has actually finally come out to respond to those tweets as he dropped a song this Friday called Gustavo. And you know, on the song he basically says some things. This is what he actually came out and said. So I'm not gonna read all the lyrics, I'm just gonna read the parts that I feel pertain to AKA or might pertain to AKA. He said, young nigga doing wild, couple trophies on the shelf. Nigga, your shit wasn't real. Nigga, your bitch wasn't real. Nigga, that paper won't last. You think your album gon' last? Man, that shit is so trash. I'm just all up in my bag. Only gonna talk about this one time and we'll leave it to the past. Move the fuck up out of my way. Ain't you 30 and some change? No, it's not easy seeing young niggas coming off for your place. You was talking online, then you fell for the bait. No, it's over for you, nigga. Over for you, no debate. Another part I thought might have pertained to AKA, he ended off, you know, his second verse by saying, fuck all your dabs. You couldn't even make me in a lab. Now, here's the thing reading those lyrics, okay? A lot of you might come out and ask, you know, Tusco, was this, you know, directed at AKA? Okay, it's not exactly clear. He didn't come out and directly call him out. But given the coincidences that are in these lyrics and, you know, based on what happened to them, like I told you earlier in this video, you know, about those tweets that they tweeted towards each other, I will come out and say that this was directed at AKA, in my opinion. Because Shane Eagle basically comes out to say in these lyrics, look, man, your album was trash, okay? And on top of saying that your album was trash, he continues, you know, to say that, look, that album is not gonna last. And when I tweeted, you know, you basically took the bait by actually responding to that tweet. And, you know, more or less your career is over, you know. And he was basically saying, just move, you know, out of my way because it's my time at this point. And I'm not exactly sure about that final line in the second verse, but when he says, you know, fuck all your dabs, you know, you basically couldn't make me even if you were in a lab. Yeah, that could pertain to the fact that, you know, AKA basically came out saying that, nigga, I created you. And the lab part, I think, is trying to play on the idea of, you know, the lab. We usually call the studio the lab. You know, I think it's trying to play on that to basically say that, look, if me and you were to go toe-to-toe in the studio, you know, you're not necessarily as good as me, so how could you possibly create me? Now, I'm honestly come out and big up Shane Eagle, okay, for coming out and actually responding in the music. I kind of sensed the fact that him not responding on Twitter was him basically saying, okay, I'm not necessarily going to say anything to him directly. I'm just going to come out and say something to him, you know, via the music. And I think that's, you know, a commendable thing because, you know, these guys at the end of the day, they're rappers, they're musicians. So, you know, you have to respect the fact that he came out and responded to him via the music. Now, as far as the response goes, okay, for me, it was a bit like, it was okay, okay. And it was okay because when I personally listened to it, I kind of felt like he's saying a lot of stuff that he has said before, okay? Like the stuff where he says your girl's not real, you know, your girl's fake. You know, he said those things before, you know, your favorite rapper is a pop star darling and now coming out to say your music is trash. I think, you know, what he was saying before and what he's saying now, you know, is more or less the same thing. There's nothing different in these lyrics. And for the bold claims that he's making on the song where he comes out and says, you know, you took the bait and you know, he's more or less trying to say, I'm gonna end you right now. For those bold claims, I actually felt like, you know, the lyrics should have come harder at AKA and come at him maybe with something new that we didn't expect, or basically said something, or either it should have been witty punchlines for me, which was one of them was I liked the lab, you know, line. But the rest of it was more or less stuff that we've heard coming from him before. But nonetheless, okay, it's clear. Okay, Shane Eagle is after top spot in the game. He wants to be the colored guy that is running ish. And I don't see any reason why he can't be, okay? He can be that guy. And he basically feels like, you know, maybe AKA should just move out the way. I don't know. I personally think that they can both be, you know, right up there, you know, because like he said, you know, AKA is a pop star. So, and AKA also admitted that. He actually came out and said that he's a pop star. So I actually look at it and I say, look, man, AKA can exist. His sound is different. His music is different. I don't necessarily agree that his songs are trash, because I definitely feel like his last album wasn't a rap album, okay? And for us in hip-hop, to some extent, we kind of felt like he left us hanging a bit. But you know, I enjoy the music that's on that project. I still listen to it today. Shane Eagle's album was also dope. You know, that was a rap album. That was, you know, straight bars, let's go, you know, we at this. And I think it was also a dope album. So I think they can both coexist in the industry, and they can be the two colored guys that are killing shit in the game. But I don't know, man. You guys leave me your comments in the comment section, letting me know what you think about Shane Eagle's lyrics on Gustavo. Do you guys think that Shane Eagle was responding to AKA with these lyrics? And also, if he was responding to AKA, what do you guys think of the lyrics? Do you guys think that, you know AKA took the bait and it's basically over for him now? Do you guys think that AKA should also respond to what Shane Eagle has just said? And also, you guys should let me know if you guys think that, you know, AKA gotta move over for Shane Eagle to, you know, take over, or do you guys think they can coexist? Do you guys think they're both dope? Or do you guys think we only need one colored nigga running the game? You guys leave me your comments, man, and definitely subscribe. Awesome. Now wait, Emapili. I know you wanna go, but click that red button and subscribe and put some respect on a younger name, man. Awesome.